Omar was dying or dead or paralyzed. Because I got home at 7 and he'd been sleeping for most of the day. And he wouldn't wake up, he wouldn't stand up, he wouldn't do anything. And she told me, remember, she said, wake him to eat because he needs to eat. And now it's like he's back from the dead. This is fucking insane. Unless because he's so skinny, his body just needs to shut down and it's not going to wake up. I don't know. I thought you were dead, Omar, or dying, or gonna die. This is just too weird. He's eating, and his neck and back aren't broken, but he was like a rag doll. He wouldn't stand up. He was like a rag doll. There goes her brilliant idea. Wake him up. I think it's because his body needs to conserve energy because he's so skinny. This is so crazy. I'm already in a state of shock. Now I'm in more of a state of shock. It's midnight. For 5 hours, I thought that he was just, that was it. I thought he was paralyzed or something. Omar, you are something else. Mama didn't send the vet the thing. You're something else, baby. You were dying. You were dead. You're gonna die on me. You sure seemed like it. Am I in a dream? I was getting terrified because I thought, I was like, no, baby, please don't try to get up. If you're hurt, you're just going to hurt yourself more. You can't bear to watch it. But he can stand up. He has difficulty, but he always has difficulty. He wants to eat. That's not the behavior of a dying animal. Oh my God, this is crazy shit. You are something else, Mama, let me tell you. You are something else. What that something else is, I don't know. I thought you were dead. Mama thought you were dead. You're dead. You gotta be careful. You're still like falling on your head. This is unreal. I swear to God, I'm in a fucking dream. I need your food. Okay, you can eat it. Me. back from the dead? Am I in a goddamn dream? Is Mama in a dream, Holmes? Huh? Am I in a dream? This is just too weird. This is too weird. This is... this defies all logic. Yeah, each word. I thought he'd broken his neck and back, and that he was, that was it. You'd still be alive, but you have to be put to sleep. Like, this is crazy. I even had Grandma say goodbye to him. This is too weird. Remember, I didn't know how he would have gotten hurt, but I thought he twisted something in the cage. It doesn't seem like that would happen, because they're usually self-protective, you know? They said he didn't get hurt the night I dropped him to the kitchen floor. You know, they land on their feet and they were aware of their bodies. You know, they're only in this small little thing. Omar, this is very bizarre. Yeah, eat. I'm feeding it to him by hand. That's what she told me to do. Okay, I don't want him to bite me. That's the thing. I gotta get it off my hand without biting me. I'm flat. Flat. That's how she fed him. She knows what to do. I don't want him biting me. Yes, as long as I do my hand flat, it's okay. For obvious reasons, I'm not going to put him in the bathroom. I'm letting him eat right in here. I can wash this. Yeah. Wash it every time he pees on it anyway. Doesn't matter. What this reminds me of, this is fucking crazy. This is just bizarre. This is so bizarre. How can I say this? Anyway, but Omar, were you just knocked out? Were you just knocked out and not can't wake up? That's all it was all this time? Mama thinking you're dead or dying? This fucking shit. You couldn't wake him up. I figured if you can't wake him up or stand him up or to go do anything, then he's paralyzed or something. Or broke something. Meanwhile, he just wanted to sleep, which proves my point is why I don't wake him up to eat. But he needs to eat to get heavier. Oh, you put me through the ringer, Omar. Too fucking weird. Too
14 or 15. 14 or 15. Living with Dad and Diane. I lost my mom to illness. Brought home a chipmunk that I'd found run over in the road, but it was still alive, but it didn't have use of like its back legs. Like it was flattened almost, but it was still alive. Nursed the thing back to health for a month. Then one day came home. It feels like a dream, but I know that it happened. And it had gotten out of its box, because it's just in a box because it can't move, it's broken legs or whatever. And it was flitting all around through the house, through the apartment, rather. That was supposed to die. The chipmunk was supposed to die. And instead it lives and ultimately is in a position where we can let it go. And it couldn't move. It was like flattened. But obviously it wasn't like it was going to die, like life-threatening injuries, because it healed on its own. It healed. The thing healed. And it could run through the house, and then we had to catch it. Surprised they even let me keep the chipmunk. I thought you were dead, Omar. This is fucking bizarre. Now you know why I would have never let you come. I'm not gonna do that anyway. Sorry if he has to be in pain overnight and be put to sleep the next day. I'm not going to kill him myself. He was like a rag doll. A rag doll. You couldn't wake him. You couldn't stand him up. You couldn't. I thought he heard it, that he was dead. He was going to die. Paralyzed. Broken neck. Broken back. Something. And you were just zonked out. What zonked you out, sweets?